Shabbat Shalom. I want to thank all of you for joining us here tonight, whether you're joining us here on our beautiful campus or joining us from the comfort of your home as we celebrate Shabbat Shuvah, the Shabbat right between Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur. On this Shabbat, we reflect upon the work that we are undertaking to enter this year 5783 as the very best versions of ourselves, as individuals, as a community, and as a people. We'll recite special inserts during our prayers that are used only between Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur as we consider how this precious gift of sacred rest can help us in the work of Teshuvah, in the work of our repentance for the year to come. We'll invite Shabbat into our midst with our candle lighting, which can be found on page 2.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech ha'olam Asher kiddushanu b'mitzvotav v'tzivanu lehadlik ner, lehadlik ner shel Shabbat.
We'll continue with Shabbat Hamalka, a piyut, a tune that can be found on page 10 in your Siddur.
Shabbat Hamalka Meirosh Amiroredet Hakdosha Habrucha Ve'ima Malachim Tzeva Shalom Menucha Bo'i Bo'i Hamalka, bo'i bo'i hakala, shalom aleichem, shalom aleichem, shalom aleichem, ma. Malachei HaShalom.
We'll continue with the Psalms of Shabbat as we welcome Shabbat. Typically, we recite what is called Kabbalat Shabbat, a series of psalms to usher in the Sabbath day. We'll be singing Or Zeruah, which can be found in Psalm 97 on the bottom of page 14 in your Siddur.
Or Zeruah, La Tzadik Ul Yishrei Lev Simcha. Hadash Shiru L'Adonai. Light sings straight through you and back to you. We sing with joy. Raise your Chadash Shiru L'Adonai. Or Zeruah La Tzadik Ul Yishrei Lev Simcha. Raise your hopeful voice.
In Israel, there's the expression "Hamevin Yavin," those who know know. And we could easily say this about that last tune, but maybe we should let you know in case you've never seen the film or the musical. Once, that might be where you remember that melody from. It's a wonderful, wonderful film and a wonderful musical. So if you've never had the opportunity, please check it out. We are going to continue with Chadodi, which can be found on page 20 in our Siddurim. We're going to say some of those verses together, then I'm going to get you up so that we can welcome the Sabbath bride.
Lecha Dodi, Likrat Kala, Pene Shabbat Nekabela. Krat kala pe Shabbat Nekabelah. Shamor v'zachor b'dibor echad. Hishmianu el hamyuchad. Adonai echad u'shemo echad. L'shem o'tiferet v'litila. Kala pene Shabbat nekabla lecha dodi likrat kala pene Shabbat nekabla likrat Shabbat lechu v'nelcha ki hi mekor ha-bracha. Merosh mikedem nesucha, sof maaseh b'machashava tehila. Lecha dodi likrat kala, pene Shabbat nekabla. Boi v'shalom ateret bala gam besimcha uvetzahala toch emunei am segula boi chala boi chala. Lecha dodi likrat kala pene Shabbat nekabla. Lecha dodi likrat kala pene Shabbat nekabla.
Page 28.
Barechu et Adonai ha-mevorach, Baruch Adonai ha-mevorach, le'olam va'ed.
God, we thank you for the gift of listening. And we pray that you forever inspire us to open our ears to the stirring sounds of your creation, to open our minds to breathtaking new experiences and perspectives, and to open our hearts to the beauty of our fellow human beings. May it be your will, God, that we always find you in listening, and that we always remember to listen. Words of Shema can be found on page 34.
Shema Yisrael, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad, Baruch Shem, Kevod Malchuto, Leolam Va'ed.
Please be seated. We'll continue with words of Micha Mocha on page 40.
Come on.
We'll continue with our tradition's lullaby prayer, the Hashkivenu prayer, which can be found on page 42. Tonight, we're going to use a tune that was first introduced to our congregation by David Cates, our previous music director. He would teach the kids this rendition, which includes some lyrics from Matis Yahu, when they would sing on Friday nights. So if you remember those days pre-COVID when we would have the students, they'll be back again, by the way, so don't worry. You might remember this tune. Otherwise, you may have heard your kids singing it around because we still use it at Camp Wise. We use it on our Camp Wise Sundays experience, our once a month camp experience for religious school students. So we hope you enjoy.
Sometimes I lay under the moon, I thank God I'm breathing, and then I pray, don't take me soon, 'cause I am here for a reason. Sometimes in my tears I drown, but I never let it get me down. So when negativity surrounds, I know someday it'll all turn around, because all my life I've been waiting for, I've been praying for the people to say that we don't want to fight no more. There'll be no more war, and our children will play one day, one day. Hashkivenu Adonai Eloheinu Leshalom Vehamidenu Shomreinu Lechayim. Hashkivenu Adonai Eloheinu Leshalom Vehamidenu Shomreinu Lechayim. One day this all will change, treat people the same, stop with the violence, down with the hate. One day we'll all be free and proud to be under the same sun, singing songs of freedom like one day, one day, one day.
Yes, the jazz hands are great. You can also do it online. You can do applause online. That's wonderful. Page 44, we'll continue with Vishamru, a prayer for Shabbat.
Ledorotam berit olam Berit Olam. Meini Uvein B'nei Yisrael. Oti Oti Le'olam. Meini Uvein B'nei Yisrael. Oti Oti Le'olam Veshameru B'nei Yisrael Et HaShabbat Et HaShabbat La'asot Et HaShabbat Ledorotam Berit Olam Berit Olam.
As we turn now to our prayer for healing, it's impossible not to consider those suffering in Florida and Cuba from the devastation wrought by Hurricane Ian. There are those who grieve, there are those who lament, and there are those who remain in danger, wondering if they will ever reach safety. And for them, we pray. Are you watching, God? Have you seen the innocent swept away? Are you listening, God? Have you heard their cries? Be with them, God. Be their strength and their comfort. Let them know you are near. And work through us, God. Wake us up. Show us how to help. Use us. Shine through us. Open our hearts so we can comfort the mourning. Open our arms so we can extend them to those in need. Shake us out of our complacency, God. Transform our helplessness into action, our generosity into charity, and turn the prayers of our souls into acts of kindness and compassion. For this we pray and more. Our prayer of healing can be found on the middle of page 253.
Mishabeirach avoteinu mekor habracha leimoteinu. May the source of strength who bless the ones before us help us find the courage to make our lives a blessing, and let us say, Amen. Mishabeirach imoteinu mekor habracha. Souls in need of healing with refuah shelema, the renewal of body, the renewal of spirit, and let us say
our silent tefillah, our silent Amidah prayer can be found beginning on page 48 and proceeds all the way through page 62. A couple quick notes. If you turn to page 48 and you look at the Hebrew or the transliteration or even the English, you will see a little section in very small print that says Shabbat Shuvah. This is Shabbat Shuvah. So we would add all those inserts that we would find throughout our prayers, which make them maybe a little longer, but they do help us to focus on the task at hand, the task of teshuvah, which we set ourselves upon in these days between Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur. I invite you to rise, to turn to page 48 in your books, and pray either with the words of the Siddur or whichever words you find in your hearts this evening. When you're finished, please feel free to be seated.
Shalom Rav can be found on page 60. You may sit when you're ready.
Shalom Rav, Al Yisrael Amcha, Tasim Leolam. Shalom Rav, Al Yisrael. Atahu melech Adon lechol ha-shalom v'tov b'einecha levarech et amcha Yisrael echol etu v'chol sha'ah b'shlomecha. Sefer Chaim, Beracha v'shalom, Beracha v'shalom, Ufarnasa tova, Beracha v'shalom, Nizacher v'nikatev lefanecha, V'chol amcha beit Yisrael L'chaim tovim U'shalom Baruch atah Adonai Oseh ha-shalom.
So lost in all of our high holidays may have been the realization that football season started. Some of you didn't miss it. It's okay. This Sunday, Philadelphia sports fans are going to cheer an opponent as if they never had before because the currently undefeated Philadelphia Eagles host the Jacksonville Jaguars. Now, it's not that the people of Philadelphia have any particular love for the city of Jacksonville. Rather, the people of Philadelphia still appreciate Jacksonville's first-year coach, Doug Peterson, who only 5 seasons ago delivered Philadelphia its first and only Super Bowl championship. You see, Peterson was flying high after the 2017 season, his second as an NFL head coach, when he bested the New England Patriots with a series of daring and dazzling plays, if I say so myself, as a Philadelphia fan. And almost overnight, he went from an afterthought to a celebrity. He released his own book later that year. Everything was working right. And yet, 3 years later, he was jobless. Now, after a year off, he's back at the helm with his new team, and the early results are good. The Jaguars, who have been a laughing stock for years, are now 2-1, following victories against top competition. And Peterson credits his success to a year away from the job. This is what he said. "It was just really a good time for me to step away, to refocus and regroup myself, and come back with a lot of energy and passion, and pour everything I learned in 5 years into this job, and to make it the best I can be, to have a little more fun with what we do, and not to be so stressed out all the time." This week's Parsha Vayelech, just two parshiot from the conclusion of the Torah, also considers what life can look like off the job. As the Israelites prepare to enter the Promised Land, Moses reminds them that they must go on without him, that Joshua will take the reins of leadership as they cross the Jordan River. Now, we know from previous chapters that Moses remains in the wilderness as punishment for his failure to follow God's instructions at the waters of Meribah. But Moses doesn't really mention that here. Instead, he says, "Ben mea ve'eslim shana anochi hayom, lo uchal od latzet v'lavo." I'm 120 now. I can't just come and go anymore. Now, that's a very particularly tangible metaphor, coming and going, that Moses uses to denote the responsibilities of leadership that he can no longer sustain. The same idiom is also used to describe the leadership of Joshua, King David, and King Solomon elsewhere in the Hebrew Bible. And it connotes the sum of skills and resources necessary for Moses to lead. Moses isn't simply suggesting that he lacks the strength to make the journey across the Jordan. He's indicating that he no longer possesses all the abilities he needs to effectively lead. His stamina, his intellect, his interpersonal skills, his resilience and drive, they're just no longer up to the challenge. And so, his job finished and his journey complete, Moses dutifully relinquishes command to a new generation of leaders and retires. Doesn't sound too bad. But what happens if the job isn't finished or the journey isn't complete? What happens when our stamina, our intellect, our interpersonal skills, our resilience and drive have been exhausted and we still have miles to go? What happens when we feel like we can no longer come and go anymore like we need to? For Coach Peterson and his contemporaries in the professional football field, the answer is relatively simple. Join the great resignation, take a year off, come back invigorated. But we can't just all quit our jobs. Most of us probably wouldn't want to. So the question becomes, what exactly happens in that year away? Can we copy it on a smaller scale to restore our ability to come and go? For Peterson, who went from college quarterback to professional backup quarterback to coaching a high school team to an NFL assistant coach to a 5-year NFL head coach without any break in between, last year provided a welcome opportunity to pause, to reflect, and to reprioritize. He took time to be with his family, to assess his career, and to move on from the way his job ended in Philadelphia. In essence, he hibernated. Like a squirrel going away for the winter, Doug Peterson lowered the temperature paused from the constant search for food and rode out what would otherwise be a treacherous winter to enter spring refreshed and reinvigorated. And maybe we're meant to do the very same thing. In her 2020 bestseller, Wintering, author Catherine May examines the slowest season in our calendar to teach us how we can all step back and recover in the dark, away from the pressures of spring, summer, and autumn. And it begins, she suggests, with a simple admission that we're no longer capable of being who we want to be, at least not in this moment. Now, that's a shocking thing to admit, but only when we dwell in that shocking truth, she suggests, can we truly release ourselves from those ever-present obligations and give ourselves a chance to slow down our routines, to turn down our body temperatures by a degree or two, and maybe get some sleep. It's not easy. It requires us to confront our own ineffectuality, not just for a moment, but for a season. Something that seems much at odds with our American addiction to industriousness. But if we really seek a true recovery, if we really wish to give the best of ourselves to those who rely upon us in the new year, then maybe it isn't shrinking away to take some time. Maybe it's just courageous and strategic to plan for a season that we must say, I can't come and go anymore, but give me some time and I'll be back to you. May this opportunity to reflect, to reconsider, to become our best selves carry us not just through these days from Rosh Hashanah to Yom Kippur, but allow us to take the time we need to really be our best selves in the year 5783. May we all be sealed for blessing in the Book of Life. Gemar Chatima Tova. Going to continue with a prayer for the United States of America. God and God of our ancestors, we ask you to bless this nation and its peoples. Open our arms and our hearts and our minds to one another. Let us never withhold your gift of dignity from our fellow human beings. Grant us the determination to preserve the wonders of creation and the steadfastness to safeguard all created in your image. Teach us to honor the guardians of life and liberty, whether they proudly wear the uniform of our nation or defiantly wield signs of peaceful protest. Grant us the resolve to spurn the enemies of freedom and justice, whether they brandish the weapons of fear, of greed, or of hatred. May we remember that we can only reap the fruits of virtue, of peace, and of love by sowing the seeds of virtue, of peace, and of love. Then shall justice roll down like water, and righteousness like a mighty stream. Amen. A prayer for the state of Israel can be found on page 259 in your Siddur.
Avinu Shebashamayim, Tzor Yisrael v'goalo, Barech et Medinat Yisrael, Reshit Smichat Geulateinu.
Please join me, O Heavenly One, Protector and Redeemer of Israel. Bless the state of Israel, which marks the dawning of hope for all who seek peace. Shield it beneath the wings of your love. Spread over it the canopy of your peace. Send your light and truth to all who lead and advise and defend, guiding them with your good counsel. Establish peace in the land and fullness of joy for all who dwell there. Amen.
Avinu Shebashamayim, Tzor Yisrael v'goalo.
In a moment, we'll continue with the Kiddush, which can be found on page 5. Before we do, we take a moment to acknowledge that there might be many reasons that we come to Shabbat. Some of us come in sadness, some of us come in memory, but some of us come to share our joys. So I want to ask, does anybody have any simchot that you are celebrating here with us? If you're at home, you can feel free to share your simchot with us online. If you're here in person, do we have any birthdays? Any anniversaries, retirements? Any this month? Any weddings? Any moments of joy that were experienced this past week? Yes, stand up if you experienced a moment of joy this past week. Some of you did not experience moments of joy this past week. I'm so sorry. But I do hope that you will join us in rising on page 5 for the Kiddush.
Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, borei peri hagafen. Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, asher kiddushanu b'mitzvotav v'ratzavanu. V'shabbat kodesho b'ahava uvratzon hinchilanu. Zikaron lemaaseh bereshit, ki hu yom techilah lemikra ekodesh, zecher litziat mitzrayim. Kivanu v'harta, v'otanu kidashta, mikol ha'amim. V'shabbat kodshecha, be'ahava uv'ratzon, hinchaltanu. Baruch atah Adonai, mikadesh ha-shabbat.
L'chaim.
Please remain standing for Aleinu, page 282 at the bottom.
Aleinu l'shabeach l'adon hakol, l'tet gedula l'yotzer breshit, shelo asanu kigoye ha'aratzot, velo samanu k'mishpechot ha'adama, shelo sam chelkenu kahem, ve'gor aleinu kechol hamonam. Ve'anachnu korim u'mishtachavim u'modim lifnei melech malchei hamlachim hakadosh baruch hu. Ve'ne'emar ve'haya Adonai le'melech al kol ha'aretz b'yom ha'hu, b'yom ha'hu.
Please be seated. Before we continue, I want to apologize. I was a little flippant before in our discussion of joy because, of course, there are some people who have not experienced joy within this past week because they were concerned about someone, about their health or about their safety, or they may have been mourning the loss of a loved one in recent days. And Shabbat is for you too. And we're glad that you're here with us in person and online. And as we think of those for whom we're mourning tonight, if you're here, I invite you to please rise. If you are at home, I invite you to please mention the names of your loved ones so we can honor their memory together with you, whether you're sitting Shiva, the first 7 days of mourning, or Shloshim, the first 30 days of mourning a loved one, or in the first year of mourning the loss of a parent, or commemorating the Yahrzeit, the anniversary of a loved one's passing. We honor the memory of your loved ones together with you. Words of Kaddish Yatom can be found on page 294. Yitkadal v'et kadash shemei rabba, b'yalma divra chirute v'yamlich malchute, v'chayechon uv'yomechon uv'chayedecho beit Yisrael, v'agala uv'izman kari v'imru amen. Yehe shemei rabba mevorach le'olam olomeo maya, v'yitparach v'yishtabach v'yitpo'ar v'yitshomam v'yitnase, v'yitadar v'yitale v'yitalal shemei dekudisha b'richu, le'ela ule'ela min kol birchata v'shirata, tushbachata v'nechemata, da'amiran b'alma v'imru amen. Yehe shlama rabba min shemaya, v'chaim aleinu v'al kol Yisrael v'imru amen. Ose shalom b'imromav, hu ya'ase shalom, aleinu v'al kol Yisrael v'imru amen. Zichronam livracha, we ask that the source of blessing make the memories of our loved ones a blessing to us now and always. And together we say,
amen.
Amen. Please be seated. Before our concluding song, which will be Biado, which we can find on page 321, it actually takes a lot of people to both make Shabbat happen here and broadcast it into your homes. And we're so grateful to everyone, grateful to Andrew and Lauren for lending us your amazing voices, to Tali and Jeff for your amazing music, and to our incredible communications team, Margaret, Roz, Brian, Andre, for helping us to bring this into the comfort of your home. And we're mostly grateful to you for celebrating Shabbat with us and making this a Shabbat of community. Page 321, Biado.
Shabbat shalom.
Shabbat shalom.